Now we will first start working on physical layer, Annamaya Kosha. The body we are carrying, which is made of flesh, bones and blood. The physical body, Annamaya Kosha. Because it is strengthened or weakened by food, it is directly built by food, Anna, it is called Annamaya Kosha in Sanskrit. The body can be an ultimate place for us to rest or a great bondage. The goal is to evolve the body into enlightened physiology. Please listen. How your body should be. How your body should be. The goal. The body should be a vehicle through which you can manifest anything you want. Not just your health or wealth or better relationships, anything you want, you should be able to just manifest. The physical layer, Annamaya Kosha, is part of the material world. Whether it's a rock or tree or a man, all have physical body. In this physical body, you carry the patterns of fear. Please understand. The samskaras of fear. See, in each layer, you carry different patterns. Different patterns are recorded in different layers. In each layer, different patterns are recorded. In the physical layer, the patterns of fear is recorded. Please understand these patterns. By and by accumulate certain power, even though they cannot function independently without the power of your consciousness. Because of its long time existence, they themselves acquire certain powers. Like early morning cup of coffee. Once you build the habit of early morning cup of coffee, without that your life cannot move. It's almost like a day has not started if the coffee is missing. I'm not saying coffee is wrong. I'm not saying coffee is right, but all I am trying to tell you is compulsion is wrong. Compulsion is wrong. That stops your self-actualization. That stops your self-actualization. First, the engrams, patterns, samskaras, incompletions you have in your physical layer. Let's dig out those physical layer patterns, internalizing incompletions of fear. Please listen. Dig out all the fear layers, fear patterns. Recollect the earliest memories of your life. Write down all the incidents and the conversations you had about fear of losing your name, fear of losing your fame, fear of losing your identity. You have multiple layers of fears stored in the physical body. Recollect the earliest memories of your life and write down the incidents and conversations you had about fear of losing your physical health, fear of losing your mental health, and our fear of losing the body parts in accidents. Same way, recollect the earliest memories of your life and write down all the incompletions you had about fear of losing your wealth and all your possessions. Recollect the earliest memories of your life and write down the incidents and conversations you had about fear of losing your loved ones, fear of losing the love of your loved ones. Recollect the earliest memories of your life and write down the incidents and the conversations you had about fear of the unknown. So start penning down as if you are talking to me. Let's dig out the patterns and engrams you carry in the physical layer, in the physical body. Listen. Some deeper insights into this fear pattern. See, when I utter the word fear pattern, it means all your fears are patterns, not facts. Please listen. Your fears, when they overpower you, look like fact. When you overpower them, you realize it is pattern. Understand? When they overpower you, it looks like fact. When you overpower them, it looks like pattern. Now, all we need to do something so that they can never overpower you. They can never make you powerless. They can never make you powerless. Listen. We will have to do something so that we can never become powerless. Listen to this truth. Internalize. All fear is nothing but pattern making you powerless. Because you became powerless, the pattern looks like a fact. It's like there is a hero and a dupe for the hero. When hero is dead, powerless, dupe looks like a hero. Pattern taking over you, making you powerless, and makes itself look like fact. That is the worst thing can happen to you. Please listen. That is the worst thing that can happen to you. All fears are ultimately rooted in fear of death. All fears ultimately rooted in fear of death. Actually, whenever you become powerless, that is the real moment about which you need to be afraid. Not the death itself, please listen. If you don't become powerless, death is just transition. If you become powerless, collapse. Actually, death leads to such an unknown, unable to understand space. In your life, if at all you have to be afraid of something, only you have to be afraid of becoming powerless, nothing else. Nothing else need to be worried. You don't need to worry. You don't need to be afraid of anything else other than feeling powerless. Feeling powerless is the only thing about which you need to be afraid of. You need to be worried about. Now, I'll lead you into a process which will strengthen your inner space so that you will never fall into powerlessness. Never the pattern can take over you and make it look like a fact. Pattern taking over you makes itself look like a fact is the worst thing that can happen to you. It's like you are a dupe, breaking your head and putting you unconscious and then taking over your place, making himself look like you. So listen, this process awakens your Kundalini, strengthens your powerfulness, never allows you to fall into powerlessness, so that patterns can never take over the place of fact. Anything when you know it is a pattern, you will never be afraid. As long as you think it's a fact, you will be frightened. Whether it is a ghost, fear of losing name and fame, or death, fear of accident, everything. Only if you feel, oh, it may become fact, it is there, then you will be frightened, powerless. If you know it is just a pattern with which you are suffering, suddenly the fear lost all its strength and vigor. Now the process I'm going to lead you. Very simple process. It's from Shaivagama, Sivajnana Upanishad. Let me read out the verse and then give you the technique. Evameva Durnishayam Krishna Pakshagameshiram Taimiram Bhavayan Rupam Bhairavam Rupameshyati. The English translation, in the same way, a dark night in the dark fortnight, by contemplating for long over the circumambient darkness, the yogi will attain the nature of Bhairava. Please listen. I'll give you the technique now. Meditate on intense darkness. It will actually put your mind to your natural state where your Kundalini can start spreading all over your system. Your body will start getting powerful. Please understand, darkness is only worshipped as Kali, and Kalabhairava in Hindu tradition. Don't be afraid of darkness. It is the agitated Western mind, Western mental setup which is afraid of darkness. But the original darkness is beyond light and darkness. It is like a beyond the frequency of the light. If you see the whole cosmos, it is darkness, intense darkness. It is not just darkness, it's energy too. It's energy too. Meditate on darkness as intensely as possible. You may even feel that you have forgotten your body. It is okay, because when you meditate on that darkness, your Kundalini Shakti will be awakened. You will experience the real light. As on now, whatever you know as light is not real light. Meditate on darkness, you will experience the real light.